Hi, and welcome to this heavily branded edition of the Freethink Progress Report. Today we're going to be talking about ordinary people that have volunteered their time and energy to help with the COVID response. My name is Mike Wood, and I'm a director at Freethink. If you're thinking I look like that guy from the rapping robot video, I actually am that guy.
What's up?
I've just gained at least 10 pounds during quarantine and desperately need a haircut. I think most of us wish we could do more to support our health workers, right? Anna Azvalinsky, a science writer in New York City, spun up a nonprofit called Meals for Heroes that delivers meals to health workers from local restaurants that are desperately in need of support as well. They're now delivering 600 meals a day to 13 hospitals in some of the areas where COVID has hit the hardest in New York City.
We're delivering to emergency departments, to ICUs, respiratory departments, or any healthcare worker that's directly working with COVID patients. And also prioritizing overnight shift as it's more difficult for healthcare workers to get food. These hospitals they're food deserts, so the cafeterias are closed and the restaurants around them, they're not open. And if you're in an ICU unit, you can't leave to get meals.
In just 5 weeks, they've recruited 11 volunteers and actually just opened up a branch in Seattle that's now delivering meals.
I mean, Meals for Heroes is for sure my self-care. So maybe I have to stay up a couple extra hours at night to do this, but getting these emails from the healthcare workers, there's this community that has opened up. It's really, really giving me energy and hope for the future. And as long as we keep getting donations, we'll keep going.
If you're considering supporting this effort, Anna's kids made this very calm and sobering PSA that I think you should check out.
Don't eat Meals for Heroes, please.
Gabe Witz, an 18-year-old in Washington, D.C., realized that he could 3D print face masks and started an effort to bulk print them for health workers. What started as a project to 3D print masks for his family members quickly grew into a GoFundMe that got $40,000 in less than 24 hours.
You know, feeling supported and validated by people all over the country is, you know, one of like the most unique and beautiful experiences that I've had.
They're now setting up a print farm of 14 printers that can print up to 150 masks per day. Gabe has now recruited 11 volunteers to help with printing, sanitation, and distribution to hospitals and other institutions around DC.
I've never really worked this hard in my life. I've never felt this kind of compelled or driven to get up and do things every day.
So what are your special skills when you're 100 years old? How about literally just walking? A World War II veteran raised over $40 million for healthcare workers in the UK. With the help of a walker, Captain Tom Moore completed 100 laps around his garden in a fundraiser for his 100th birthday. The captain also received over 100,000 birthday cards, including one from the Queen of England herself. Don't sleep on old people, my friends. This pandemic has been overwhelming. I think we've all at times felt pretty helpless to do anything about it. These stories are just a few examples of ordinary people that simply decided to do something. They serve as examples to inspire all of us to think about ways that we can help, big or small. We put a couple ideas in the comments below. If you know of any volunteer efforts that you think we should be covering, or frankly, any stories that you think are interesting, send us an email at tips@freethink.com. Honestly, we love hearing from you guys. Well, maybe not all of you guys, but most of you guys. I'm just kidding. We love hearing from all of you guys, except from some of you. I'm kidding. Don't unfollow us.